I want to give it a word of advice to all people who are married. This isn't for people that are boyfriend or girlfriend or people that are trying to get to know each other. This is for people that have gotten married, who've put their hand on the Bible, swore those vows. How do you expect to have a marriage if you don't tend to it? Marriage is like a plant. And I'm not talking about some wild plant that grows, you know, crazy, left alone out in the, you know, middle of nowhere. It's not the same kind of plant. This plant you have to tend to every day. You have to give it attention. You have to water it and feed it. If you don't, it will die. And when people make excuses to not be with their spouse, they're neglecting their marriage, aka their plant. If you don't have time, make it. Because once you said, I do, you took away the ability to make any excuses about spending time and being a correct spouse, according to the Bible. That time was, you were supposed to do that when you were boyfriend and girlfriend, not as husband and wife. It changes the dynamics when you marry someone. They are no longer just your friend. They are now connected to you and they're your partner. If you choose to not make time, that's you, and you're responsible for that. There's no sane pastor that is worth a grain of salt that will divorce anybody who hasn't even given it a try. And before they can decide that, they have to sit down with both parties. Your pastor does. And talk to both of you before they make a decision. This is why when you get married in the church, you need to think about what you're doing. Or get married with your hand on the Bible. Because if you haven't talked about and discussed everything that you believe in or your ways, you're going to be in trouble. People need to understand that. Again, it is so vital. And this goes to the men mostly because they're the ones with the problem with making time. If you don't have time, make it. Because it's your responsibility. You're the man of the relationship, the marriage. And it's your responsibility as the head to make sure everything flows smoothly. If you don't, you're the one that's going to have to answer for that when God calls you home, not the wife. The man is the head and is going to have to answer for everything he does when he faces God. Remember that. Have a blessed day.